Good morning, Joy Gospel Radio FM family. It is a pleasure once again to be able to come to you with a word. You know, every time I do the devotion, I always say to God, I don't want to come with my own words. I don't want to come with my own agenda, but God, I want you to speak through me. And as humans, we get to a point where sometimes we question, and you want to make sure that you're doing that which you're called to do. And it's so funny that I was listening to the devotions this week, and just the messages that have been coming, and then God, he just kept confirming what he said to me, confirming it. And I'm like, you know, sometimes the Spirit speaks to you, and sometimes it's a personal word, and you tend to want to keep it because sometimes it seems a little harsh. But I was sitting at my kitchen table and I got a pen, and I don't know about anybody else, but whenever I get a pen in my hand, I start doodling, just writing. And I kept writing, do I really believe God? Do I really believe God? Like, do you really believe me? Like, just kept writing that. And I was like, I left it and I went to bed. And the next morning, the Lord woke me up with this message. And I pray that this message will bring us all to a place where we take inventory. We just stop and just really see if what we are doing, if it's in the will, and if we really believe God when he speaks. Because if we do, we will act upon his word. We will live different. We will speak differently. Praise God on this morning. Let's go to God in prayer before we get into the devotion. Mighty God, this morning, I want to thank you for life, health, and strength. I want to thank you for daily provision. I want to thank you that God, we're in the land of the living with our hearts and minds stayed upon you with our faculties working, oh God, and we are in tune with your spirit. I pray that this morning, the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in thy sight, oh God, and the words will go out and find good ground. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our devotion is entitled this morning, do we really believe God? Do we really believe God? And it's coming from our main scripture is John chapter 20, verses 24 to 29. And it reads thus from the NLT version of the Bible. One of the 12 disciples, Thomas, nicknamed the twin, was not with the others when Jesus came. They told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he replied, "I won't believe it unless I see the nail wounds in his hands, put my fingers into them, and place my hand into the wound in his side." 8 days later, the disciples were together again, and this time Thomas was with them. The doors were locked, but suddenly, as before, Jesus was standing among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your hand into the wound in my side. Don't be faithless any longer. Believe." "My Lord and my God," Thomas exclaimed. Then Jesus told him, "You believe because you have seen me. Blessed are those who believe without seeing me." Praise God. Do we really believe God? To doubt means that we express a feeling of uncertainty or lack of conviction. We are skeptical. We question the truth of fact about something, disbelief. 2 Peter 3, verse 9 admonishes us, "The Lord is not slack concerning his promises, as some men count slackness, but long-suffering towards us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance." Another passage of scripture tells us, "And to whom swore he that they should not enter into his rest, but to them that believe not." So we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. That's Hebrews 3, verses 18 and 19. The word of God tells us that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Romans 10, verse 17. The opposite of faith is unbelief. So we see that Thomas was in the passage of scripture said he will not believe until he actually touched Jesus. Essentially, he's like, I'm not going to believe unless I touch Jesus. Some of us have the doubting Thomas syndrome of not believing until we see. We as believers, we are taught that we ought to walk by faith and not by sight. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 7. We cannot use the physical realm to guide our walk, our interactions with God. God operates outside our five senses that we are restricted or constrained by. Have you ever heard someone say or talk about the sixth sense? This is the part of our extrasensory perception where information is gained not through the recognized physical senses. For me, I say that is faith at work. Hebrews 11 verse 1 tells us what faith is. Faith is the vehicle that moves the hand of God. Do we really believe God this morning? Kenneth Hagin says, faith is grasping the unrealities of hope and bringing them into reality. I'm going to say that again. Faith is grasping the unrealities of hope and bringing them into reality. Do we believe God? Do I really believe God? Listen, when your reality goes against God's word, where the word says faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God, we have to step out of self. We have to step out of flesh. We have to step out of the physical realm that is trying to dictate our existence. It's trying to dictate our reality. We have to get into a mode of worship where our spirit man becomes engaged with the spirit of God, where we can be reassured as his promises are yea and amen. I don't know about you, but many a times when I read the word of God and I get the encouragement, I get the tenacity, the know-how, and I say, yes, God, you said that you have a plan and you're going to do it. And as you keep going, what the word told you and what your reality is saying is totally opposite. It's totally different. And you have to fight. You have to fight to keep that word alive. Let me tell you, the enemy is not going to come at you to get you at a place where you are so involved with God and you're happy. He's going to come at the place where you're least reassured, where you're least confident. And he'll keep chipping away at that. Because when he chips away at that part that is not so settled, that is not so firm, then now you start taking it over to the parts where you are settled, where you're confident, because you're saying, well, if this part is not working out, if this is not, well, maybe this one is not really what I think it is. And you start playing on the doubts and of our minds, and you start playing with what our reality is telling us. That's not what God's word said, because God works in the spirit, and we have to pull those things from the realm of unreality and pull it into reality. We have to work our know-how, not what we see, but what we know. We got, because our eyes will fool us every time. It's not it's not the things that we see are permanent. They're temporal. It's the things in the spirit. Those are the things that are permanent, and those are the things we have to pull into the realities of this realm, because he says, lay not your treasure here on earth, but lay it up where moth and rust cannot corrupt it. So we have to lay up our treasures in God. We have to lay up our confidence in God. We have to trust God that what he said he will do, he will do. And all when we don't see it happening, we still gotta believe. Do I believe God on this morning? Many a times it's hard. You know, people see you going along and they think, well, you have it all together. What you see on the outside is not necessarily what is going on the inside. On the inside, we are fighting, you know, because we are physical beings, and it will go, it will show that we are pulled towards the physical realm. We tend to gravitate towards the things that we can see. That is why we need to cultivate a lifestyle that is connected to the Spirit of God. For as Romans 7:23 tells us, but I see another law of my members warring against the law of my mind and bringing me into captivity to the law of sin, which is in my members. The law of sin reigns in the physical realm because that's where we act out our disobedience. That's where we act out our attitudes. That's where we act out our lack of compassion. That's where we act out unforgiveness. All of these are things that you cannot see, but you act them out. But then the word of God said, let this mind be in us as it is in also, which was also in Christ Jesus. So then when our mind is controlled by the Spirit of God, we can put our members under subjection this morning. Do I really believe God? Do we believe God on this morning? So we have to get into a mode of worship where our spirit will connect with the Spirit of God. And it is when we worship Him that we know that we must worship Him in spirit and in truth. And that's when we will come back to the place where we start believing God, start believing His word, start acting upon His word. Because He is infinite, He's eternal, and He's unchangeable. If He said it, He will perform it. If He said He will do it, we need to believe that He will do it. Hallelujah. Can we believe God this morning? It is a fight, but we will fight the good fight of faith. We will lay hold on eternal life and hold fast a good profession before many witnesses whereunto we are called. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12. Can I really believe God? God, help thou my unbelief on this morning. This is a personal question that we can only answer and search out for ourselves. God is calling us, His people, to the level of the supernatural, because we are going to have to step into the realm of calling those things that be not as though they were and are. This is not an easy fate, as we are influenced by the physical realm more than the spiritual realm. And I don't know if it's because we are not as fully committed, if we are not as fully submitted, or we are not as engaged with God as we think we are or as we should be. Do I believe God this morning? Do we believe God? Hallelujah. God, do I believe God as I really should, with all that God has done for me? Because He's a trustworthy God this morning. And this message is really personal for me, because I'm going through a phase where I need to know without a shadow of a doubt that, God, I believe You. And that question that was asked, do you believe me? It's for me to search out. It's for us to search out and find out if we really believe the words of God. Because His promises, they're yea and amen this morning. If He said it, He will perform it. If He said it, He will do it. If we trust Him with all our hearts and lean not to our own understanding this morning, He will direct our path. He will instruct us. And He says He knows the plans that He has for us. Plans of good and not of evil, to give us an expected end. What is your expectation this morning of God? And do we believe Him? Father God, we want to thank You for Your mercies. We want to thank You for Your grace. Because God, everything that You have said is connected to Your word and connected to our reality. For us to realize and understand that we can believe You. But it's for us to get to a place that we ourselves tell ourselves that we need to believe You. We must believe You. We should believe You, God, because You are not a man that You should lie, neither the son of man that You should repent. For Your words, they are yea and amen, and we can trust You this morning. Help thou our unbelief, God, so we can stand on Your word and Your promises. so that we can believe you with every fiber of our being this morning, that we'll put self under subjection, so we'll yield, not to our own understanding, but to you, God. Have your way, oh God, have your way, have your way. Let us not come in this form and fashion week after week, God, leaving and not coming to a place of total submittance to you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Do we really believe God?